Today, my presentation topic is enzymes in clinical diagnosis. Enzymes are biological catalysts present in every cell of the body. So, in this presentation, we will learn how enzymes help in the diagnosis of any disease in clinical state. Topics which I have covered in this presentation are introduction, alteration of plasma level in disease state, plasma enzyme as diagnostic tools, isoenzyme and the disease of the heart, quaternary structure of the isoenzymes, diagnosis of myocardial infection, and newest markers for myocardial infection. In introduction, there is a figure which explains that when the whole blood is centrifuged, it is divided into three portions. The upper one is called the plasma, the middle one is called the buffy coat, and the lower one is called the electrolyte. Plasma is the fluid, non-cellular part of the blood. Usually, laboratory assay of enzyme activity, most often used serum, it is obtained by centrifugation of whole blood after it has been allowed to coagulate. Plasma is the physiological fluid, whereas the serum is prepared in the lab. Plasma enzyme can be classified into two major groups. First, a relatively small group of enzymes are actively secreted into the blood by certain cell types. For example, the liver secretes zymogen, inactive precursor of the enzyme involved in blood coagulation. Second, a large number of enzyme species are released from the cell during normal cell turnover. These enzymes almost always function intracellularly and have no physiological use in the plasma. In healthy individual, the level of these enzymes are fairly constant and represent a steady state in which the rate of the release from the damaged cell into the plasma is balanced by an equal rate of removal of the enzyme protein from the plasma. The presence of elevated enzyme activity in the plasma may indicate the tissue damage that is accompanied by the increased release of intracellular enzymes. Alteration of plasma enzyme level in disease state. Many diseases that cause tissue damage result in an increased level of intracellular enzymes into the plasma. The activities of many of these enzymes are routinely determined for diagnosis purpose in the disease of the heart, liver, skeletal muscle, and other tissues. The level of a specific enzyme activity in the plasma frequently correlate with the extent of the tissue damage. Thus, determining the degree of elevation of a particular enzyme activity in the plasma is often useful in evaluating the prognosis of the patient. Plasma enzymes as diagnostic tools. Some enzymes show relatively high activity in only one or few tissues. The presence of increased level of these enzymes in plasma does reflect damage to the corresponding tissue. For example, the enzyme alanine aminotransferase is abundant in the liver. The appearance of elevated level of alanine aminotransferase in plasma signals possible damage to the hepatic tissues. Increase in plasma level of the enzyme with a wide tissue distribution provides a less specific indication of the site of the cellular injury. This lack of tissue specificity limits the diagnostic value of many plasma enzymes. And the disease of the heart. Most isoenzymes, also called isozymes, are enzymes that catalyze the same reaction. However, they do not necessarily have the same physical properties because of genetically determined differences in amino acid sequence. For this reason, isoenzyme may contain different number of charged amino acids and may therefore be separated from each other by electrophoresis. Different organs frequently contain characteristic proportion of different isoenzymes. The pattern of isoenzyme formed in the plasma may therefore serve as a means of identifying the site of the tissue damage. The plasma level of creatine kinase are commonly determined in the diagnosis of myocardial infection. They are particularly useful when the electrocardiogram is difficult to interpret, such as when there have been previous episodes of heart disease. The figure shows the ribbon representation of creatine kinase structure. Quaternary structure of isoenzymes. Many isoenzymes contain different signals in various combinations. For example, creatine kinase occur as three isoenzymes. Each isoenzyme is a dimer composed of two polypeptides called D and M subunit associated in one or three combinations, CK1BB, CK2MB and CK3MM. Each creatine kinase isoenzyme show a characteristic electrophoretic mobility. The figure show that CK1, that is BB, mainly found in the brain, while the CK2MB mainly found in the cardiac and skeletal muscle, and CK3MM mainly found in the muscular injury. Diagnosis of myocardial infarction. The figure show that when interior wall interact, red thrombus on the ruptured atherosclerosis plaque causing blood flow blockage. What is myocardial infection? Myocardial infection is also known as heart attack, occur when blood flow decreases or stop to part of the heart, causing damage to the heart muscle. The most common symptoms is chest pain or discomfort, which may travel into the shoulder, arm, back, neck or jaw. Myocardial muscle is the only tissue that contains more than 5% of the total creatine kinase activity as the CK2MB isoenzyme. Appearance of this hybrid isoenzyme in plasma is virtually specific for the infarction of the myocardium. Following an acute myocardial infection, this isoenzyme appears approximately 4 to 8 hours following onset of chest pain, reaches a peak of activity at approximately 24 hours, and returns to the baseline after 48 to 72 hours. US markers for myocardial infection. As we know that important enzyme in the investigation of the heart disease are creatine kinase, lactate dehydrogenase and aspartate transaminase, while important enzyme in the investigation of the liver disease are aspartate transaminase and alkaline phosphatase. The figure show that the blue ribbon is troponin C, the green ribbon is troponin I, and the magenta one is the troponin T. Troponin T and troponin I are the regulatory protein involved in the myocardial contractility. Myocardial contractility can be defined as the tension developed and velocity of shortening, that is, the strength of the contraction of the myocardial fibers at a given preload and afterload. They are released in plasma in response to cardiac damage. Cardiac troponin 1 is highly sensitive and specific for damage to the cardiac tissue. Cardiac troponin 1 appears in plasma within 4 to 6 hours after a myocardial infection, peaks in 8 to 28 hours and remains elevated for 3 to 10 days. Elevated serum troponins are more predictive of adverse outcome in unstable angina or myocardial infection than the conventional assay of creatinine kinase 2. Thank you, and now you can understand how enzymes participate differently in clinical diagnosis.